Hi students, we have completed ionic equilibrium, most of the important topic. Now let us see, is our preparation up to the current examination level or not? For that I am going to give you some examples of previous advanced questions. Okay, so if you are able to solve them up to the advanced level question, previous advanced level question, then definitely your preparation is good enough. Okay. So this is one of the best way to test your preparation level, okay? And after that we are going to, based upon those questions, we are going to do some questions also, okay? So let's get ready for the advanced level previous examination question, okay? So first question I have selected from the advanced 2014. First question I have selected from the advanced 2014. Okay, so what was the question, what you have to solve, is your preparation level up to the mark or not, let's see. Okay, okay, this was the question. MX2 dissociates into M2 positive and X minus in aqueous solution, okay, with the degree of dissociation is how much? 0.5. it was an integer type question. Find the ratio of moles in presence oblique in absence of dissociation. Okay, moles of particles in presence oblique absence of dissociation. Number of moles of product. Okay, so let's take answer here. MX2. Okay, so it is giving as M2 plus X minus. This is what already given. Now here, but two X are there, so that it should be divided into two parts. Okay. Now let us take it is 1. Okay. In absence of particle, it is 1. 0 and 0. Okay. This is when no dissociation in absence. Understood? So if dissociation takes place, okay. If dissociation takes place, one minus, it will be how much? 0.5. Okay. And this will be how much? 0.5. This will be how much? 2 into 0.5. Okay. So, number of moles after dissociation, in presence of dissociation, number of moles in absence of dissociation. Okay. So, it will be 1 minus 0.5 plus 0.5 plus 2 into 0.5 divided by 1 plus 0 plus 0. Okay, so this and this will get cancelled. Answer will be 2 by 1, that is equal to 2. Okay, so this was the advanced level 2014 question. You can cross check with the question paper. Okay, but to avoid the confusion, they have used freezing point, depression freezing point word, that is what this ratio. Okay, so note down this question. Let us discuss 2018 question. One more question related to the given in the 2018 advanced examination. I feel you don't get any problem in solving this question. Okay, note down this. Okay, this is the advanced level, advanced 2018 question. It is related to solubility. Okay, solubility and solubility product, but the problem with this question is it is combined with salt hydrolysis also. Okay, so here see, solubility of a salt of weak acid, what is given? Salt of weak acid at pH is equal to 3 is y into 10 to the power of minus 3, and the value of y is, y you have to find out. This is also integer type of question. Okay, so here given KSP of AB is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 10. Then KA of weak acid from which it is generated is 10 to the power of minus 8. Okay. So you can give a try. If not, you can pause the video and you can give a try. Then cross check with my explanation. Okay. So pause the video if you are trying, then you can continue with my explanation. If pH is equal to 3, okay, so that means H positive concentration is equal to how much? 10 to the power of minus 3. Okay, so second thing, it is given as KSP of AB is equal to concentration of A plus into concentration of B minus, okay, is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 10. Understood? And solubility, S is equal to Y into 10 to the power of minus 3. Understood? And what else given? Ka. So, Ka formula is concentration of H plus into concentration of B minus divided by concentration of HB. Okay? This is weak acid. Understood? So, HB is equal to, how much it is given? 1 into 10 to the power of minus 8. These are all things given. Okay? So, now you will get idea what you have to find out. Only this you have to find out. Okay? So, already you must be knowing A positive, B minus. Okay? So, it is a weak acid. So, anionic hydrolysis will undergo. Understood? What to A, B minus will react with water. Anionic hydrolysis, in salt hydrolysis I have told you, it is going to react with the H positive anion hydrolysis to form the HB. Okay. So, this part I will again explain. First, you note down all these values. First, read the question properly. Write down all values together. In advanced examination, there won't be any problem of timing. Only, you should understand as quick as possible. For that, whatever is given in the sentence form, better to write in the equation form. So, you note down up to here, then I will explain how to solve further. Okay? Okay, there are two things here, solubility product and hydrolysis, salt hydrolysis. Let us take this hydrolysis, solubility is S and S. Okay? But it is undergoing hydrolysis also. Suppose degree of hydrolysis is X. Okay? From this it is removed, so therefore everything will be in the container only. Okay? So this is related to what? Solubility product. This is related to what? Salt hydrolysis. Two topics are combined together. Okay? So, and H plus concentration. How much it will be? 10 to the power of minus 3. So, this will be X concentration. If it is minus X, this is minus X, this will be X. Okay? So, dissociation constant, Ka. Ka, if I write, Ka already I got 10 to the power of minus 8. Okay? In place of H plus, I can write as a 10 to the power of minus 3. In place of B, I can write as a S minus X. And in place of the HB, it will be X. Okay, so this is what I got it. Understood? What I want? I want solubility. Okay, so there will be an equation. There will be an equation in terms of the S. So I am simplifying it here. So this and this will get cancelled. 10 to the power of minus 5x is equal to what? S minus X is equal to S minus X. Is it understood? Just 10 to the power of minus 5. This is cancelled. So, X is equal to S minus X. Okay. Now, here if I wanted to find out KSP. KSP will be concentration of A into B minus. Okay. S into S minus X is equal to S into S minus X. KSP was already given. So, 2 into 10 to the power of minus 10. Understood? So, this will be S square minus SX is equal to, or if I bring it this side, 2 into 10 to the power of minus 10 is equal to 0. Okay? So, this is going to be a quadratic equation. What it is going to be? A quadratic equation. If you simplify, finally you will get the answer. Okay? Just note down, I will give you the simplified answer. So, on simplifying this equation, I am getting 4 into 4.47 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So, our integer y is equal to 4.47. This is our answer. Okay. So, make a note of it. Then we will do some other question. Okay. Note down this. Okay. Okay, this is a question selected from the simultaneous solubility. Simultaneous solubility means two sparingly soluble salts are joined together with one common ion. Okay, it is not some new topic or it is not some different topic. So, to make you understand that, this question is selected. Okay, so BaSO4 on dissociation gives Ba2+ + SO4 2-. Okay, so let us take this solubility as X. So this is also will be X. Okay, now second thing what it is given are S1 we can take. Okay, S1 X is only okay. X is okay. Okay, next BaCrO4. So it will also give Ba2+ and CrO4 2-. Understood? BaCrO4. So let us take this solubility is Y, this solubility also will be Y. Okay. So but if as the simultaneous solubility, here what we will write Ba2+ is from X from here, Y from here. So this will be X+Y and Y from here, X from here. This is also will be Y+X or X+Y. Both are same. That is the difference between the simultaneous solubility and simple solubility. In simple solubility, this Y will not be there. Okay. So, I will write KSP. See, its KSP is already given. Its KSP is given as, how much it is? 10⁻¹. Its KSP is given as 2.4 × 10⁻¹. Okay. BaSO4 is 10⁻¹. It is 2 × 2.4 × 10⁻¹. This is what given. And they want X and Y. What they want? X and Y. X is the solubility of BaSO4. Y is the solubility of BaCrO4. Question, is it understood? Can you solve? You give a try. If not able to solve, then go through my explanation. Okay, so if you are able to solve, then it is well and good. Pause the video, then you try yourself. Okay, so now I am going to change this. So if you are confident, you can continue, pause, and then you are checking with my explanation. Okay, so see, according to this, 10⁻²+ is equal to Ba2+ × SO4 2-. Is it understood? And according to this equation, so Ba2+ × CrO4 2-. Is it understood? So if I divide them, this and this will get cancelled. So what I will get in the numerator of this, it will be X. Okay? And it is going to be Y. So it is ultimately this and this will get cancelled, 1 upon 2.4. Okay? So what I can write is, from this Y is equal to 2.4X. What I can write? Y is equal to 2.4X. Is it understood? Now, what I am going to do? I am going to take any one of this. Preferentially, preferably, which one is better? That is up to you. So, for the time being, I am erasing this and I will solve it here. Okay? So, I am going to solve it here. So, Y is equal to 2.4X. In this equation, X+Y × X. This is what KSP is equal to 10⁻¹. Okay. So, here it is X and here also I will write 2.4X. In place of Y, I can write as a 2.4X × X is equal to 10⁻¹. Okay. So, like that, if you simplify this equation, you will get X. I have simplified this, I got 5.42 × 10⁻¹ molarity. Okay, so this is the solubility of BaSO4. Understood? So now I will put this value here or here, anywhere you can put down. Now then I will get the Y value. Y value as 1.3 × 10⁻¹ molarity. This is the 1.3 × 10⁻¹ molarity. Okay, so note down this. Okay, now we will discuss another type after integer type. We are in the next type, matrix match. Okay, so this matrix match I have selected because it covers wide area of salt hydrolysis buffer solution. Both will be covered here. Okay, pH of mixture, this we have topic studied. Understood? Now let us see 25 ml of 0.1 molarity NaOH added to 50 ml of 0.1 molarity CH3COOH. Okay, so it will act as a basic buffer, acidic buffer, or pH greater than 7 or pH equal to 7, that we have to identify. Okay, so for that, how you will identify? See here, number of moles of NaOH, 2.5 mole. Okay, so it will be 0.25 milli equivalent of base is there. Okay, otherwise you can take 25 ml also, not a problem. So it is going to be how much? 2.5 milli equivalent of base is there. Understood? And 5 into 0.1. So 5 milli equivalent of acid is there. Okay, 5 milli equivalent of weak acid, 2.5 milli equivalent of strong base is there. After the reaction, which is left over? Which is left over? Weak acid is left over. Here I am writing in the first condition, after reaction, we will have weak acid. Okay, how much after reacting this will be? 2.5 will be left over. And what will be forming? Salt will be formed. Okay, salt, that also salt of weak acid and strong base will be formed. How much it is going to be? 2.5. So you can understand, weak acid and salt of weak acid with strong base. So what it will be? Weak acid is also there, salt of the weak acid with strong base is there. So it is going to be what substance? Very good, it is going to be acidic buffer. Okay, so A answer is Q. Is this understood? No doubt about this? Very good. So let's see, and there is no chance pH cannot be more than 7 because acidic buffer. What it is? Acidic buffer pH cannot be greater than 7. Acidic buffer pH will be less than 7 acid. And pH cannot be 7, that depends upon the what? Ka and pKa. Okay, if pKa is equal to 7, then only we can say. Understood? So for first A, answer is what? Q. So I am erasing this. Is this clear? If not clear, I will explain in the other way also. Don't worry. Okay, I will explain in other way so that you can understand other parts. See, CH3COOH plus NaOH. Okay, what it will give? CH3COONa plus H2O. Is it understood? So this was 5 milli equivalent, this was 2.5 milli equivalent. 25 into 0.1, 5 into 50 into 0.1. Okay, 5 and 2.5. This is before reaction. Which is limiting here? This is limiting. So this will be 5 minus 2.5, it is going to be 2.5. This is 0, this is going to be 2.5. So salt and weak acid. Therefore, it is an acidic buffer. Is this understood? So A answer is what? Q. Now let us see about the B part. Okay, so in this question, what we have? Strong acid and strong base. What we have? Strong acid and strong base. So, and their pH, or sorry, milli equivalent also same, 25 into 0.1, this is also 2.5, this is also 2.5. So acid plus base, complete neutralization. Complete neutralization means what it is going to give? pH is equal to 7. Both are strong acid. So I am writing answers here. A answer is Q only. So B answer is only S, because it is not a buffer. Strong acid and strong base cannot form a buffer. And both are strong, both milli equivalents are same. Therefore pH is equal to how much? 7. pH is equal to how much? 7. Okay. Now let's see about the C part. Let's see about the C part. Okay. So here we have strong acid and weak base. So there are chances that basic buffer may be there. Understood? So let us see. For that, what we will write? HCl plus NH4OH, after the reaction, it is going to be NH4Cl plus H2O. This is what reaction is going to be. Now, HCl, 25 into 0.1, so this is going to be 2.5. 50 into 0.1, this will be 5. So, after which is limiting, this is limiting. So, this is going to be 0, this is going to be 2.5, this is going to be 2.5. So, finally, we are left with... base, weak base and salt of the weak base with strong acid. So, this is going to be basic buffer. So, C answer will be P. And as it is a basic buffer, pH also going to be greater than 7. So, P, R. Okay. Now, let us see about the D part. Okay. So, noted this. So, let's hope it should be easiest like this. Now, here we got the weak acid and weak base. And see, Ka is equal to Kb. So, automatically, without any simplification, 25 into 0.1, 25 into 0.1. So, it is also going to be salt of weak acid with strong base. As both of them are same, therefore, pH is equal to 7. Okay? Already, I have told you formula. Half into PKW plus PKa minus PKb. So, Ka, Kb are same. So, this will get cancelled. It will be 7. So, D answer is S. Okay? Note down this. I hope you understood this matrix match. Very good. Okay? So, we have studied some basic requirements. Analyzed our preparation level, is it up to advanced level or not, okay? So, if required, we will do some more questions that depends upon your likes and comments. If you are giving a good comments, some more questions are required and some more number of likes and more information you will give it to your friends, then accordingly I will work on it. Because I wanted to work as per the requirement of the students. If more students requirement, more views will be there, more likes will be there, then I will be working in the direction. The direction of my videos will be as per the requirement of the students. If you feel that already we know this much not required, then less views, less requirement, then I will work in the other direction. Okay. So, I hope all of you will give a like to this video and I will try to make some more videos like this on each and every chapter. Okay, first I will analyze the previous advanced questions, then according to I will give you suggest some questions related to the previous advanced questions, so that your ultimate aim of getting a good seat in a good college with the required batch will be fulfilled. Okay, required stream, required course will be fulfilled. Okay, so bye-bye from WhichChem. I hope all of you subscribe now. As of now, if you are not subscribed till now, subscribe and press bell icon so that you can get the notification like that whenever I upload a video in the YouTube. Okay, see you, bye-bye.